So y'all, this is a perfect time to have story time. I got my grandma right here. So what was it, last week? The weed smoking thing was last week?
Yeah.
Last week, right? So the new neighbors, he maintenance live on the property, so he moved in next door, right? Don't leave, you part of this story.
So it,
get over here in the tell your part of the story. Anyway, so we weren't gonna say nothing. We kept smelling weed coming through the vents. We weren't gonna say nothing. We was being nice. So then I told my grandma, I said, okay, I'm gonna take care of it, whatever. But she took it upon herself, called maintenance, and she had a little conversation. So he came in the house, so I'm watching them on the camera, so I'm listening to her talking to him. And so he was like, no ma'am, no ma'am, it's not me smoking. It's coming from the people downstairs up under me. Nigga, you lying. How the smoke from up under you come and travel all the way upstairs and going into my girl? That don't even make sense. So anyway, he was like, so he gave us a whole bunch of little scents to put up in the vents. First off, how are we gonna put it up there? You got to do that. So then we ain't smell no weed for like a few days, maybe like 4 or 5 days. Then it was sometime last week. I'm laying on the couch and I'm like, I said, I know that ain't what I think it is. So I get up and I go in my grandma's room and I open her door. And I went in her bathroom. Bro, as soon as you open the door, just smack me in my face. Weed. So I said, grandma, is you okay in here? She's like, I'm all right. I'm going to say nothing. So I went in my room. And then I heard her heavy breathing, maybe like 30 minutes later, just heavy breathing. So I came out. She's sitting on the couch trying to lay down and sitting propped up. I said, O-H, no. So I called the courtesy officer, left him a long, lengthy message, and I called the leasing office because I know they was closed, but I left them a long, lengthy message. I said, listen here, hold on. I said, listen here, these neighbors smoking weed, but ain't supposed to be no smoking on the property, blah, blah, blah. I said, it's coming through the vents. It's affecting my grandmother's health. She can't breathe. She got breathing problems. I said, if something happens to her and she has to go to the hospital, me and such property is going to have a problem. So the next day, the manager immediately called me. Ma'am, Mrs. Ingram, we have rectified the situation. If you have any problems, let me know, because we have spoken to them, and da-da-da-da-da-da-da. I done spoke to my manager and head corporate, and they said, if anything else, blah, 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 thank you. First off, because they knew if something would happen to her, and she would have got sick and had to go to the hospital. Brother, I'm suing. I'm suing because that's in the contract, and leasing, no smoking on the property. And if niggas are smoking on the property, is affecting her health. That's the problem. If you're gonna smoke, go outside. Go on your balcony. And then he gonna lie and tell my grandma, ma'am, it ain't me. It ain't me. If I do smoke, I go outside. Which one you smoke or you don't smoke? Which one is it? Tell the truth. Have we smelt any smoke?
Nope.
Don't play with me. Don't play. I know I crack jokes and make funny videos. But when it come to her and that little dog, Charming, where he at? I don't know where he at. When it come to them too. And my mom and my brother and my nephew. Wouldn't come down. I don't play. She couldn't breathe. She was, it's giving me a headache. She's probably getting high. She getting high. My grandma was high in the living room.
Well, now I was sick from that smoke.
Anyway, I don't play. I just want to tell y'all that. Story time. Okay, love y'all. Bye.